Hey y'all, this is Jerry here again with you, Country Folks 100. This week, what I was going to do is kind of look at some of our deer hunting setups, the way we hunt over here. Of course, we hunt on private property, so you know, we can cut shooting lanes in some of these areas. You know, we don't have a problem with that, but you know, we'll show most of those. I have one thing here. I've got a couple stands here. This is my newest one. It's an old man climbing stand. I've got an old, I think an API stand there. But yeah, these stands here we can use in certain situations if I need to hunt a little area that we may have not been planning on hunting before. You know, you could always take a climbing stand and carry it down there and set it up. They're real good whenever we hunt refuges, wildlife management areas or wherever. You know, you got to have a good climbing stand to carry in there with you. But that's not what we're going to be using most of the time this year. You know, we'll go down here in the woods, and we got about two or three stands. I'll show you those spots, you know, of and let you know what we usually use. All right, we'll head on over there right now. All right, I've made it over here to the other side of the property. We've came over here to one of our main stands. What we've got here is a little box blind. This is Evan's stand. My brother Evan Stan, and this is where his son Wesley hunts a lot of the time. He's killed a couple of deer last year here. I've killed a couple 8-points here. Evan's killed some good deer down here over the years. We've decided to go with the box blinds on the ground. As you can see, it's just kind of on a little pallet there built into it. It's got a roof over the top. You can hunt down here in a rainstorm and stay as dry as you are back at home. We can put a heater in there. It doesn't matter how cold it gets down here. You know, you can stay pretty warm. You know, we got some windows there on the side. But we usually just open up that front one. And we got a real comfortable chair in there too. And we've got that coupled up with shooting lanes. We'll have shooting lanes down through this way here and also down through here. After Hurricane Laura came through, I can see now, this is the first time I've came down here since all that, but there's down trees all in the way down there. That's all gonna have to be cleaned up by me here in a few weeks. It's September now, but we'll get that done later. But we'll couple up a fixed position stand like this. It's sitting on the ground. So if, I just heard something down there. So in case the kids want to hunt in them, you don't have to worry about them falling out of a stand and hurting themselves. You know, you can stay comfortable in there. And that's going to cause you to hunt longer. We don't have a lot of big deer around here, so it takes a lot of seat time to be able to finally see one. You may see one or two good deer a year, so you got to be ready. And we'll put out corn down there, but not really for what you think. We'll put corn down there just in front of the trail cameras so that we can kind of see what deer we have. All those pictures of any good bucks are going to be at night, so we just kind of wait for them to, whenever they start rutting, you know, you'll start to see them every once in a while during the daytime. I'll show you the similarities with a couple of our other stands like this, just to let you know what I'm talking about. All right, now we're down here at the other one. This is where I'm mainly going to be hunting this year, or I'm hoping to anyway. This little stand, I just fixed it up last spring. It's never been hunted in. I came down here and cut some shooting lanes. See, that's, you can probably kind of see it there. If you come around this brush pile here and down through that way, it's another little shooting lane straight through there. But that's the way we do our shooting lanes. We just kind of cut a little trail through the trees. And if you notice, this stand here is set up just like the other one, pretty much. It's on a ridge or a hill. It's in some a mix of hardwood and pine timber, you know, and it's to where it can still sit on the ground, and you know, to where, like I said before, you know, if the kids want to hunt in them, you know, they don't have to worry about them falling out or anything like that, like I would if it was in a climbing stand. But it's pretty much the same setup anywhere you go. And I'm not saying this is the best way to do it or the right way. It's just the way we do it, and it works for us. So, you know, and I know a lot of people that are veteran hunters may not, you know, care to look at this or anything, but, you know, if you're starting out in hunting and you've got a little piece of property and you just want to know how to hunt it, that's kind of what we would do. And you know, to where if we can put a ground blind, you know, just sitting on the ground, cut a shooting lane, put out some corn, get the deer coming in there pretty good, and or the does coming in, and the bucks are going to follow, and we're pretty much waiting on the rut to happen, you know, to be able to see the big deer. But we got one other stand we'll look at before we go, and we'll head on over there right now. Okay, we're down here at this stand. This is one where I killed a big doe at this past year. It's on our videos. This is really Naomi's stand. Whenever she has a chance, you know, she can come down here and hunt it. But it's basically the same setup. If you look, you know, you got, it's just a different type. You know, it's a got angle iron on it on the edge with plywood in it. And it's setting up on a ridge, and there's shooting lanes going down the hill there, you know, that you can see real good through there. Over here is the main shooting lane. I see there's another big tree that's falling into that shooting lane. So I see I got some work ahead of me with that. But, you know, that's basically, you know, the way we hunt. You know, it's different little areas. There may be some slight little changes to each one, but with all of them, that's basically our setup. Try to get as high as we can to where we can still have a grounded stand and hunt over shooting lanes. These bucks that come through here in the North Louisiana Piney Woods, they're going to be coming through quick, and they're not going to take a lot of time, so we have to be ready for them. You got to be able to take a long shot. Now for us, a long shot may be 100 yards, you know, which is nothing for most people, but for us, that's a pretty long shot, because, I mean, you can see the woods that we're in here. So yeah, if you can see 100 yards through that, you know, that's a long way. But I can see, hear some people in the distance. Sounds like they're sighting in their guns, getting ready for hunting season. And we'll probably do some shooting videos ourselves here before too long. I'm gonna go ahead and get off here and go. Y'all remember to subscribe to the channel. Hopefully we'll have some deer videos to show you from down here in the woods this year. And we'll talk to y'all later on. All right, bye.